If there were a need to restore the original default settings to your Devio, this can be done all at once by performing a factory reset. The primary way to accomplish this is via the pinhole button on the rear of the CR1. Before going forward, please be sure to understand the following. A factory reset will make changes that cannot be undone without accessing Devio's web page and/or the system administration utility. This means that if you do not have access to these interfaces, you should not go through with this process. There are many parameters that are affected. Here is a list of those that you would most likely be concerned with. The CR1 will revert back to DHCP and so could potentially fall off the network. This will not affect your ability to use Devio, as a network connection is not required, but it would be problematic for your system administrator if they are remotely maintaining Devio. If you do have the credentials to remotely access your Devio system, note that if you no longer know the IP address, its internal web page may no longer be an option for you. Finding the unit in question via the SAU software or with a direct connection utilizing link local addressing would be necessary. A Devio system can be manually ID'd with a unique name and location to make it easy to distinguish between multiple devices from within the SAU. A factory reset will default Devio's device name to its serial number and its location to unknown. This would be an inconvenience at most, but it could be a significant one if there are many devices that are being kept track of. Any record of the last performed auto setup will be erased. The CR1's indicator LED will show red, reflecting this. It will be necessary to run auto setup again to recalibrate the system. If you've seen the other tutorials here, you'll know that the CR1 will accept video from your PC via either USB or HDMI. A factory reset will return Devio to its default behavior, which will allow video via HDMI only. This is important to consider before resetting the device. If you are currently using the USB input for video and perform a factory reset, that video will no longer be active. It can be re-enabled in the system administration utility or the device webpage. Similarly, the telephone headset interface option will be disabled after a factory reset. If your telephone is connected to Devio, that feature will have to be re-enabled via the SAU before you could resume use of it. Remote access to a Devio system is password protected. A pinhole reset will revert this back to the factory default credentials. Your Devio system's administrator will have access to this information. If your DTM1 was in end of the table mode, it will no longer be. The 20 watt output impedance setting resets to 8 ohms. Remember, there are two pinhole buttons on the rear of the CR1. One for factory reset and one for auto setup. If you are about to perform an auto setup, keep this in mind. As you can see, accidentally recalling all factory defaults can be problematic. If you believe your Devio needs a factory reset, it's best practice to alert your system administrator first. Details on all of these parameters are available on Biamp's support website.